Okay, so Dr. Beeper, we're just getting started on the right shoulder. We're looking at it from the back to the front. Everything that you see is magnified 30 or 40 times on the screen. We're just getting our first look inside. This is a great cannula you see coming in the front of the shoulder. It's coming through a part of the shoulder called the rotator interval. To the left of that is the biceps tendon. And you can see a little bit of fraying at the biceps anchor. And we're going to smooth that out a little bit and make sure it's not a more significant detachment. Next is the rotator cuff. And the cuff looks intact in terms of tearing. We're going to take a spinal needle, see if we can locate the calcium deposit. Now we've moved to look down the front of the shoulder. The anatomy actually looks pretty good. Some significant problems with the ligaments of the anatomy here. That's the anterior band of the inferior humeral ligament. See a little bit of chondral damage there. Bottom of the glenoid is our tapering. See how loose that is. And you can see that that's a little bit loose, so we can help with that. So we're looking from the front. The shaver's now coming in from the back of the shoulder. You can see this area that had cartilage is quite a bit loose. I don't want to remove anything more than I have to, but I sure don't want to leave a loose flap like you had. And now this is the anterior labrum that you can see is a bit loose. That should be okay. It was this cartilage, this articular cartilage that I was more concerned about. Trying to make sure the edges are stable. And I think that's it. So let me back up and give you the overall view. You can see that it's kind of the bottom anterior. This is the middle of the glenoid. This is the bottom of the glenoid or inferior aspect. So it's just kind of inferior anterior aspect of the glenoid. There you can see the anterior band of the inferior glenoid humeral ligament. Okay, so now we're done with the debridement of the cartilage. We've examined the labrum pretty closely, and even though the IGL attaches right there, that labrum is stable, so that's good news. Look around the back there. And now we're going to come back and make our decision on the biceps tendon. We've released the biceps, you can see it there. Now we know that this won't progress, and hopefully you shouldn't have any pain from there. We're going to go ahead and go up in the subacromial space and have a look at the rotator cuff and tie down the biceps tendon now. Okay, so we've tied the suture for the biceps tenodesis. There it is right there. That's securing the biceps. And now we're just making sure that we've made some little vent holes for any calcium. You really don't see much. There's a little plate maybe, but nothing that is going to require us taking down the rotator cuff tendon. And that's also good news. Showing you how we check and kind of using the most needle of the sound to bring the calcium out from there. So good. And the cup itself is certainly intact. The deposit's right here, but it's small, and I think we're not going to have to worry about that anymore now that we've taken care of everything else. We've done our decompression. So we're going to finish up, or I am going to finish up the decompression.